Hotep Love, good morning.
Hello.
The federal elections, well, not the federal elections, but the mayoral elections are coming up. So, what I want to know is this election, because there's still some unanswered questions that I have from Barack Obama's federal election. So, one is, I want to know, who is the person that invented the middle name? Does anybody know? Who is the person that invented the middle name? So, for instance, Malik Zulu Shabazz, for instance. How he has a middle name. How Zulu? Who invented that middle name? I know for him it was his parents, but like, who was the first one, like, ever in existence to invent a person having a middle name? So if your name is John Thomas Smith, who invented Thomas? Like, who was the first person to have a middle name, and who was the one to invent it? I just want to know for history's facts. I did notice when I was given congressional representation of D.C. that a person with one name was unable to get registered, but I figured out how to get them registered, which is what people weren't, the people who were on the ballot weren't telling the people. So the way that you can get voting rights, if you have only one name, is when you go to register at the polls, is you have to put in a zero for your middle name and your last name. So if your name is just Mandela, and you don't have a first name or you don't have a middle name or a last name, all you have to do is put Mandela for the first name and zero for the middle name and zero for the last name, and it'll come out on your voter registration card as Mandela. And I did it like that for a reason. Because when I ran for congressional representation, y'all know me as the lady. Many people know me as the lady. So I just used one name, the lady.
Hello.
So I wanted to know who invented the middle name. You know, as a youth coming up, one of my close friends used to tease me because I didn't have a middle name. So I came up, I invented this middle name that I used to go by sometime. I was like, whatever, I do have a middle name. My middle name is Shalili. Look, I don't have a middle name, ladies and gentlemen. My gods and goddesses of my, I do not have a middle name. I was not born with a middle name. I want to say that most blacks, don't want to vote because they don't want to serve in a jury. But this is the thing, we need black people to serve on a jury, which is, it's not only because of the lawyer why black people are losing the cases, but what's happening is that more black people are choosing to have a bench trial. So when they do offenses and they get caught, they're choosing to go the bench trial route, which does not allow you to be tried by a jury. I mean, it's an easy way to get over it. I mean, you have the judge and two lawyers. You have your prosecution lawyer and your defending lawyer, and then you have the judge. So you don't have to go through the whole processes of a jury, of convincing 12 people that you did not do the crime. But this is the thing. Some trials need a need a jury because the offense is either bigger or we just need a jury because some people do that. So voting does allow you to get put on jury. So don't be afraid to serve on the jury. We need people to serve on the jury. Okay? We need educated people to serve on the jury. That's how you become a expert in your field. We need you to serve on the jury. Now, I haven't served on a jury in many years, but you can serve on a jury. So, serving on a jury is not a bad thing. You do get paid for it, ladies and gentlemen, my gods and goddesses of my art. You do get paid for serving on a jury. So, you know, when you're asked to serve on the jury, just serve on the jury, you know, as long as you got your mind straight, you know, serve on the jury. I have to admit, I'm guilty myself of abusing the system a little bit, like, because way back in the days, I used to work a whole lot. And because I worked a whole lot and I worked from home and I was a stay-at-home mom working from home, I abused the system. So when I got the notification in the mail to serve on the jury, I always opted no, because I was the head of the household, so I had to take care of my babies. It would have cost me a whole lot more to serve on the jury versus continuing what I was doing. So I always used the medical excuse, you know, hey, I'm sick, I'm not feeling well, in order to get away with not serving on the jury. My fault, my bad. Okay, but what I did do was still get involved. I still went up to the courtroom to see how the cases were doing. Yes, if y'all see me in the courtroom, I was the lady sitting in the back making sure that your case was okay, because I know that there are crooked attorneys out there. So just don't think that just because I didn't actually serve on your jury that I didn't have your back, okay? Because I did. Now, who invented the middle name? Anybody know? Anyhow, all right. So what the GLP can do for the Federal Trade Commissions Act is they can negotiate a fair trade to where American stores.
Only accept
purchases with Nelson Mandela brands or with RANDs. So I have a store and it's called the Rainwater Store. So what I want to do is see if I can negotiate with my Fruits of Islam, my FOI and NOI, my gods and goddesses of my art. I want to see if I can negotiate with them to just purchase, we're gonna go with CDs only in the store, with Nelson Mandela brands. Now, let's just say the Rainwater Store accepts Nelson Mandela brands as a form of payment for CDs only. Now, if you also have your own store, would you accept a legal contract from Donald Trump to do the same for your store? Would you accept a legal contract from Donald Trump to do the same? Yes or no? Actually, this is why I say Donald Trump ain't doing too much. You know what I'm saying? But let's just say we want to give him the right to do a little bit of something, because with us, Black Power Cartel, he really ain't doing too much, you know what I'm saying? But let's say we could get Donald Trump to go to other stores and negotiate that type of successful contract with another store. For example, the bookstore where we did the event in Texas, the Black Only event. Let's just say
okay?
Donald Trump was just riding through the hood, because he has. He has rode through the hood, but he rode through the hood over by the Air Force Base, you know, which is not too far from where we were. So I want to say, what if he came over there? What if he got lost? He came over there and negotiated this contract, like gave you like the contract and said, hey, this is a presidential contract. Would you sign this contract? Here's a stack of CDs from certain artists, some big, some not so big, because, you know, I like new artists. But will you accept only Nelson Mandela rants as the form of payment for these CDs? I know in my heart that the answer is going to be yes, because I know that in this community, they want to expand the use of black dollars in the community. But let's just say it's not Donald Trump. Let's just say it's me. And I come on behalf of Donald Trump and ask them to sign the deal. I know that they would go for that, because, like I said, this is a black only event. So would you still accept a presidential contract from me for accepting Nelson Mandela rants as the only form of payment for CDs in the store? Because I know that the store doesn't sell CDs. The store only sells books and certain artifacts. So, would you accept that type of legal contract for your store if you are a black business owner? Would you accept that type of legal contract from an attorney? I would. I want to try it. Because I know when we go to Africa, we don't have to go through the whole process of going to an African bank and taking our American dollars and taking them to the counter and getting money back from Africa, and then go within Africa and spend the money. But this is what you have to do as a tourist to the United States. So say I'm an African that came from Africa, and I come to the United States. I have to take all of my rands to the bank, and I have to ask them to exchange them for the American dollars before I go out on tour to different stores and make purchases. I have to do that because I can't take my rands into the store. So I embrace migrants. So let's say, for example, President Zuma came over here, and President Zuma had a big old stack full of rands. I can accept them at my store after signing this legal contract. So, wouldn't you want to do the same? You know, you don't want to make it difficult. You want to make it easy when people come over here to tour. You know, I think that would be absolutely wonderful. And I do want to meet President Zuma, because I love a lot of his ideology. So, I would allow President Zuma to come to my store with his rants and make purchases of CDs here at my store. So wouldn't you allow that at your store? General Steady, wouldn't you allow that at your store? I know I can speak on your behalf, because I already know that the answer is yes. So Black Power Cartel all the way for life. Do Elhija is approaching, and I have been trying to do this for the last 2 years, and that get the Federal Trade Commission's more correct. So, I would allow Donald Trump to go to other stores, such as the Macy's that sells his products, or to the mall, maybe, and to the CD shops at the mall, or and negotiate a contract to where the store owner can accept Nelson Mandela rands or a type of rand for purchases of CDs only. And that would not only help the African market, but what the point is that it helps the African market. And I think that that's an actual and absolutely beautiful thing. I'm going to show you I embrace migrants all the way. So, like I said, Do Elhija is approaching again for 2017. So that's what I'm going to do to celebrate. I have my book. And so if you're interested in knowing how to build wealth purchasing money, hit me up.
Hello.
I will be happy to teach you how to invest in money so that you can build your own portfolio. Okay, and I'm hoping that I have other artists that will follow me and only use their rands, also accept rands as the only form of payment for certain CDs. So I say la, I do, I pray. I'm a praying woman. I meditate mostly, but I am a praying woman. But I do say la that the other celebrities will follow in line and use Nelson Mandela rands to make the purchases for these CDs. So I'm gonna see. I want to give it a shot. So I have some CDs for sale right now. I do have some CDs for sale right now, but you can only purchase them with a rand. So for the first elections in DC, what I was doing was I put my slogan on the dollar and I crossed out the word "In God We Trust" because I put "In Murray Trust," and I was giving them out to people who was going to go to the polls. Now, of course, in love, I trust. You know I love you. You know that. You know my people know that I love them. So, you know, that was me showing you love for saying that you would get to the polls. And plus, you were always asking me for cigarettes, which I didn't have. So, I always gave out this dollar so that you could at least get you two cigarettes from somebody else. But I did autograph it. So I know that there are people out there that do collect certain things that people use as a form of promotions for their election. Like some people collect the buttons, some people collect the ribbons. Well, you know, what if this person comes along or another person comes along and wants to accept the autograph money, you know, and actually that dollar that I autographed becomes worth a whole lot more than a dollar. I'm just saying, I don't know, because, you know, certain people collect certain things and, you know, it's just the way it is. So once again, the question for today is, would you accept a legal contract from Donald Trump at your store for the use of rands to be used as a form of payment for products at your store? Now, this is for the Federal Trade Commission's Act. So, I would. My answer is yes. So, I would. So, for Do Elhesia 2017, have a wonderful Do Elhesia. This is for the festival, and I have been wanting to have this money festival for the last 2 years. Now, we have been successfully having money festivals in the United States for a while now, which is how I got the ring. Remember the ring that I used to have with the dime on it? Well, I got that at a festival, a money festival. So on the table was a whole bunch of different jewelry that had real money on it, and I loved it. So I actually took that idea a little bit further, and I looked specifically for the coin that represented my state. So when they came out with the coins that had the different states listed on it with a certain picture, I was looking specifically for a Mississippi coin. I actually found one, and I made a ring, but I was unable to get it bonded. So it was a little bit unfinished. Like, I had to go and get it soldered. But I was so busy, I didn't have the opportunity to go over to the Hispanic shop and ask him if they would solder the ring for me. But I was so happy when I finally found the coin that I actually got rid of the dime that I had and put the Mississippi coin on there. So some of my youth was like, gosh, you not only look like a bag full of money, but you look like you're worth more than me, you know. But I don't know, you know, I didn't care about a net worth at that time, you know. Nobody cares about that when you're just talking on the street. You know what I'm saying? You can't tell when a person is homeless or when a person is rich, you know. You can't tell. You can't tell. So I don't get big about that. I don't boast about money, you know. I very I'm not one of those type of persons that picks up the Fortune magazine just to see how much a person is worth. I don't care. You know what I'm saying? Because you can lose money. You can easily go into bankruptcy. I have before. So, you know, it's real easy for a company to go into bankruptcy. And that is probably something that Donald Trump specializes in, is the company going into bankruptcy. So, but, you know, I accepted my contract from Barack Obama during his presidency for Obamacare, which is why a lot of people get a question for Obamacare when it's time for enrollment. But, again, you can get your Obamacare regardless of where you are on the map. You can get your Obamacare. But for the Federal Trade Commissions Act, I think that that's a wonderful idea, is for other stores, not only mine, but to accept a presidential contract to use RANs for the form of payment for a certain product. So my certain product of choice is CDs. And remember the question. The question is able to be answered. So if you have an answer, please feel free to comment in my YouTube section and let me know if who is the person that invented a middle name. Okay, so everybody knows that there was that the black man, and name I don't even know, it might have been because he was a slave, but I heard it was a black man that invented the second floor. So you know how you might have a house that has a second floor? Well, I heard that the black man invented that. There is a tourist area where you can visit a plantation, and it'll tell you certain historical facts about that particular plantation. It doesn't tell you about all the plantations in existence, you know, just that one. So when you go to tour the plantation, it'll tell you that one of the slaves, the black slaves, invented the second floor. What happened was this black man had a whole lot of children, but only it was allotted certain space. So what he did was he built up. So, and this is what the description says. It says he built up. So, he took, like, you know, construction things and made a second floor for them to actually walk on and sleep on. So, a black man invented the second floor. So, he built up, which could be why New York is the way that it is. You know, they built up a lot in New York. So, that's what it is. It's a real tight, you know, community. I like a close-knit community, but it's real tight in New York because, like, I mean, 1,000 people can live in one building, you know, because they build up. A lot of the buildings are high, you know, but in Texas, we have a lot of flat land, so we're more spread out. We can breathe a little bit more. But here in PA, I like it. You know, it's like almost, you know, a cross between the two, you know? But I didn't like the tight crawl spaces. Now, I'm a type of person who I was taught very well on how to take care of my home. And so in certain areas when it's real tight, I don't like the crawl spaces because it's hard for you to get through there to clean it out. I mean, you can get through there to water it. That's easy. But if you want to get through there to clean it out, you can't get through. Like, I cannot walk between some crawl spaces in these houses, between the houses, between the neighbors. So how can you get through there to clean out the gutter, you know, when you have children that walk by? And this is the riffraff that the one American was talking about, you know, when people walk by and they may take a soda can and throw it in your crawl space, or they may take a bag of chips and throw it in your crawl space. How are you going to get through there, your crawl space, to clean it out? Do I have to have some kind of inventor with a big old long pole, like a big extra long back scratcher type light pole rake. It have to be extra long, extendable one, like a vacuum cleaner hose or something to get through there to do it. It shouldn't even have to be that difficult. I don't think we should build like that anymore as a community, because we should allow, because this is the thing, when it comes to housing regulations, you have to have at least 3 feet of walking space in between you in the bedrooms when you're leasing to a person. So in the crawl spaces, why can't you have a minimum? You should have a minimum of 3 feet between the two houses. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, how is the city going to come in and tell me that my house is against city code because I don't have at least 3 feet of walking space between my bedrooms, but you know for a fact that I'm closer than 3 feet to my next door neighbor. So that's what I mean about the city code. See, when you go to a new area, the city codes change. So I'm like, some of the city codes to me don't make no sense. So I have a fresh eye, you know, to help out with that. So, but the main focus I will be doing is the Fair Trade Commission's on the money. So let's capitalize off Mandela money. FOI and NOI. And I do want to say, I loved the feeling that I got from a friend of mine, that he told me I inspired him to become a minister. Yeah, that's a wonderful feeling, you know, and I was just being myself, you know. I wasn't praying, I wasn't extra prayerful, you know, but I did pray, but I wasn't extra prayerful or nothing like that. It was just how it happened, you know, in his presence. But it was a wonderful feeling for him to tell me that I encouraged him, I influenced him, and I made him feel like becoming a minister. You know, now my religion is Ma'at, which is a form of Islam. So if that's something that he wants to do, then, you know, that's a wonderful thing. And y'all make sure y'all respect my brother, okay? Respect my brother, respect my people. So, assalamu alaikum. May you be blessed in living as the world rotates. BPC for life. Let's get to work. Black power.